Wait, what?
Right. Your turn.
Now, come on, pick up the pace.
You're a mid!
Yeah, but I'm mad at you. Now, come on, Claire. Put your foot down.
What is?
You are wild.
Yeah, I told you.
Yeah, I thought maybe you're just trying to impress me.
So am I going fast enough for you?
Maybe. Right, there's an intersection up ahead. The light is green.
Let's show him.
Maybe I'm not telling the truth.
Yeah, we know you're bitter.
Right, it is just down big enough to floor it. Come on, nearly there. Come on! No, break, break, break! Nah, they probably won't even notice. And hey, we're alive.
We are alive!
We're totally alive! Come here!
They are so gonna notice that wheel!
No, they won't. They'll think she did it. She'll swear black and blue that she didn't.
And then they'll argue and fight and end up getting a divorce, all because we went nuts for a few hours.
Yeah, we did, didn't we?
Oh my god, is that Chris?
Huh? Oh, that is some serious fashion crime. Who's the other guy?
Dr. Robe Hatter. Never heard of him.
Look at the hair!
Morning, Lib.
Excuse me? Precious archives?
So what are they doing here?
The builders found them. I was going to make a scrapbook, but I thought I'd ask Chris first.
Yeah, he'll probably just tell you to bin them.
Did you just have to roll in while I'm still here? Up all night, were we? Oh, no. No, don't tell me. The animals!
Don't. Really don't.
Animals! You're an animal!
Did you manage to get some sleep?
About 2 hours.
Oh, you shouldn't worry. I mean, if anyone's at fault, isn't it Brenda?
She's determined to make sure that I cop it. And head of nursing versus low-ranking registrar? Guess who Chris is going to believe?
No, Brenda shouldn't have given that drug without you signing off on it first.
I agree. It was a very difficult shift, but always you remained calm and effective.
See? It'll work out.
Some history you might be interested in. There's a whole box of stuff. Mum's looking at it.
Poor things, those uniforms. Stop sweating it. It'll be okay.
Good luck.
Shanti, I am going to buy you a drink.
I mean, technically, I'm at fault. I was helping an overworked junior doctor by giving the drug as requested without it being written up yet.
I think she might have been you in her day.
You two off?
Yes. See ya.
Oh, the brides. Oh dear.
I'm a bit more interested in the present at the moment. Oh, sorry. You were saying. Mark should just admit he asked me to give it. Had I not given it, he would have given it. And the patient would have reacted just as badly. But Mark wouldn't be in trouble. It'd just be down to bad luck. And had the patient not reacted, then Mark would have signed off on the drug chart without a thought.
I'm sure that Chris will understand all of this.
Nurse versus doctor. Plus, after my scrap with Tony, this could be payback time.
Kia ora, Shortland Street.
Hiya, we left some keys here last night.
Yeah, there's them.
Yeah, thanks for looking after for us.
It's my pleasure.
Hey, how's Greg?
Oh, good enough to leave for an hour or so.
Great, I bet you deserve some time out.
Yeah, a few rocky moments, but I won't bore you.
Okay, see ya.
Dead in here, isn't it?
Why, you don't hear me complaining?
Almost more fun back at the hospice.
Hey, Alice!
Playmates!
Zito, this is Shanti Kumari. She's just started at the hospital, and it is her very first time in a bath.
Well, aren't you just a pure little thing? We have to put a stop to that immediately. Mojitos all round!
Mojito has alcohol?
Nothing but.
No, thank you. I don't drink alcohol.
You're not in Hyderabad now, Nurse Kumari. Go for it.
We discussed pain relief. We decided against more narcotics because the patient was already compromised. I suggested tenoxacam, 20 milligrams. Mark agreed that was the way to go and said he'd review the patient once I'd given the drug, at which time he would have signed off on the drug sheet.
Mark, Brenda suggested tenoxacam. I said something like, it sounded like a plan, and I would review the patient once I'd finished the job I was on.
Okay, so it was a health shift, busy. You wanted to help by doing a verbal stat order. You thought you got it. You now feel Brenda misheard or misinterpreted what you said.
Yes, it was noisy. Yes, it was verbal shorthand. But Mark gave clear approval and clearly stated he'd review the patient as soon as he could. I mean, what else could he mean but that he'd review the patient after I'd given the drug?
Well, I won't attempt to play God. I wasn't there.
So where does that leave us?
That depends on this guy's recovery and on my powers of persuasion. I am prepared to argue a misunderstanding in the heat of battle. The relatives may or may not find that acceptable. If this guy remains in a serious condition, I suspect they will remain angry.
You need someone to take the blame?
No. I need all parties to understand what happened and what should have happened. You should have made your intention clearer. You should have ensured his intention in writing before you took action.
Here we go.
We all bend the rules occasionally, for good reasons. But in this case, a crucial rule was ignored. The drug sheet should have been written up and signed off by a doctor.
Nurses at fault again. I busted a gut to help you out, to make sure everything went well, especially after last week's disaster.
I'm not attacking you, Brenda.
You're letting me take the rap. Because for you, it would be one mistake too many. Or have I misinterpreted that as well?